My name is Tim Redstake. My department is responsible for identifying potential new medicines for patients with immune-mediated diseases.
And I'm Corey Wallace. My team focuses on designing and running clinical trials in immunology.
And together, our teams are responsible for making new medicines for patients with autoimmune diseases.
Like many scientists, we can trace the trajectory of our careers to pivotal aha moments, moments where we knew something different was happening, something new, leading us down a path of discovery.
For me, one of those moments happened very early in my career when patients with rheumatoid arthritis didn't have many options. And I was working in a hospital that recently administered a new treatment for rheumatoid arthritis into one of its very first patients. Later on, the patient's husband came back to the hospital very emotional to tell us that his wife has gotten out of her wheelchair, which she hasn't done in many years. Reaching these sorts of groundbreaking moments is what we all strive for.
But making large jumps in how we understand disease, it's not linear, and you may fail multiple times before you learn from all those failures. But we keep going because we know we're getting closer to having all those building blocks in place. And you know that those incremental gains over time will translate to that big jump that's impacting and finding solutions for patients.
So immunology is a very interesting but complicated field. Your immune system is there to help you get rid of the bacteria or virus. The problem with some people is that the immune system turns against the own body. In this case, attacking the joint in rheumatoid arthritis, attacking the skin in psoriasis, and attacking the gut in Crohn's and ulcerative colitis.
So far, scientists have identified over 80 distinct diseases in this category. Because the diseases are so varied at a molecular level, finding the right treatment for the right patient becomes incredibly difficult. The advent of biologic treatments revolutionized the field, but the unmet need is still incredibly high across all of the various autoimmune diseases.
Currently, we're treating patients based on clinical criteria, which has nothing to do with the cause of disease. As an example, psoriatic arthritis is a disease that manifests in multiple parts of the body. Common symptoms are swollen joints or arthritis in the fingers and psoriasis of the skin, for example, the knees. We know today that signs and symptoms in these locations respond differently to medicines. And what we don't understand is, just because of these clinical criteria, how that all works. We can learn a lot from the field of oncology, where we have a place to go to and understand what goes wrong molecularly in a tumor. Immunology doesn't have that. We don't know what to look for early on. And so that makes the puzzle very complicated. What we really want to understand is that molecular building block that drives disease, so we can build a therapy around that. Because as a physician and as a patient, what you really want is a medicine that helps you get rid of the molecular cause of a disease, not necessarily the symptom. Our teams are pursuing a host of strategies to understand the root drivers or molecular drivers of disease. The idea is to define disease not by diagnosis based on symptoms, but by something much more specific, the patient's molecular profile. Think about molecular profiling as building a fingerprint of molecules from a patient, taking multiple immune cells from a patient's blood and tissue, looking at their genes, their protein expression, and all other kinds of molecules, and with that using artificial intelligence and machine learning to build a holistic view of the disease drivers of a patient.
It's a huge undertaking, but AbbVie is well positioned for it. We've run hundreds of clinical trials, and we have access to the most comprehensive database in immunology and tools to mine it strategically. We're able to go back and look at that data with our discovery colleagues, our clinical colleagues, and our precision medicine colleagues to sort of fine-tune and look at the profiles of the patients at a molecular level and a clinical level and figure out what new solutions we could find for patients who aren't responding to current treatments.
We believe that understanding the cause of disease through that molecular profile will help us break through the ceiling effect that we currently see in our treatments. And what's also important, if we understand the drivers of disease molecularly, we can also make sure that we give the right drug to the right patient at the right time.
There are so many people affected by autoimmune disorders struggling to understand what therapies can work for them. We're committed to giving them that answer, and that's a key step towards restoring them to health.
Ultimately, our goal is to change the standard of care, to find therapies that don't just address symptoms, but can resolve and potentially cure underlying disease pathology and restore the immune system.